वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स टू द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज। आई एम आदिल मंसूरी फ्रॉम सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एलजी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। वी विल डिस्कस अ न्यू टॉपिक एंड द नेम ऑफ द टॉपिक इज सर्कुलर सीवर्स। सो व्हाई डू वी यूज ओनली सर्कुलर सीवर्स? व्हाई डोंट वी यूज एनी अदर शेप सीवर्स इन कलेक्शन ऑफ द वेस्ट वाटर? सो हियर आर सम ऑफ द पॉइंट्स व्हाई वी ओनली ऑप्ट फॉर सर्कुलर सीवर। सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज ease in manufacturing, right? Second one is less difficulty in laying. Third point is cost effectiveness. Fourth point is that it has a most efficient section. Fifth point is smooth flow. And sixth point is uniform curvature. Okay, so because of the uniform curvature, there will be always smooth flow of wastewater, right? When the sewer is laid at an angle, that is when it is laid at a slope of any angle, then the flow will be by gravity, right? Hence you will get an efficient section, right? And the construction cost is comparatively less, right? And hence it proves more effective, right? That is, the cost of sewer comes out to be effective as it has more life, right? It has more strength, it has more resistance to abrasion, right? And moreover, there is less difficulty in laying. So because of all these points, we only use these circular sievers. Okay, now let us move ahead and start with the hydraulic characteristics of the sewer. Okay, so in the previous video we discussed that we design sewers only for the flow of half full, two-third or three-fourth section, right? So it means we only design sewer for partially full condition, right? But here we will be deriving the hydraulic characteristics of sewer for two cases, that is sewer running full and sewer running partially full. Okay, so let us start with the first one, that is the sewer running full. Okay students, so here you can see that this is a sewer which is running full. Okay, so let capital D be the diameter of the sewer. Okay, so I am writing over here, let capital D be the diameter of sewer. Okay, now what will be the area of sewer? Area of sewer, that is equals to A, that will be equals to pi by 4 d square, right? Because the section is circular. Agree? Now what will be the wetted perimeter? Wetted perimeter, that is P, will be the circumference, right? That is equals to pi d. Agree? Therefore, can I say that hydraulic mean depth, hydraulic mean depth, that is equals to R, will be equals to A by P, right? We have already studied about it, which will be equals to pi by 4 d square upon pi into d, that will be equals to d by 4. Agree? Now by Manning's formula, what will be the velocity? V will be equals to 1 by n r raised to 2 by 3 s raised to 1 by 2, right? So in place of r, can I place d by 2? So replacing r by d by 4 s raised to 1 by 2, right? On simplification, we will get 0.3968 upon n d raised to 2 by 3 s raised to 1 by 2. Therefore, velocity of flow inside a sewer when the sewer is running full will be v equals to 0.3968 by n into d raised to 2 by 3 s raised to 1 by 2. Agree? Now we will be finding out the discharge. So discharge q will be equals to a into v, right? So what is a? Pi by 4 into d square. What is v that we found out? That is point, or v will be equals to 1 by n r raised to 2 by 3 s raised to 1 by 2. That is equals to pi by 4 into d square into 1 by n into d by 4 raised to 2 by 3 s raised to 1 by 2. On simplification, we will get discharge q will equals to 0.3116 upon n into d raised to 8 by 3 s raised to 1 by 2. Right? Why? Because we need to add the power of d raised to 2 and d raised to 2 by 3. So addition of 2 plus 2 by 3 will come out to be equals to 8 by 3, right? And s raised to 1 by 2 is as it is. So the discharge of flow when the sewer is running full will be q equals to 0.3116 by capital N, that is Manning's constant, right, into d raised to 8 by 3 and s raised to 1 by 2. Okay, so I'll write over here where N will be Manning's constant, d will be diameter of pipe or diameter of sewer, and s will be equals to bed slope. Okay, s will be equals to the slope at which sewer is laid. Okay students, so I think it must be clear in your mind regarding the characteristics of the sewers running full. Okay, in this video we learned about the circular sewers and the first case of the flowing water, that is the wastewater inside the sewer when the sewer is running full. Okay, and we also found out the various characteristics, that is the area, perimeter, hydraulic mean depth, velocity and discharge for the condition of sewer when running full. Okay, so I hope this much is clear in your mind. Let us start the sewer running partially full. Okay, so as you can see, this is the figure of the sewer. Okay, here I can say that let capital D be the diameter of the sewer. Okay, let AB be the level up to which the sewer is flowing. Okay, so if AB is the chord of the circle, then it will subtend angle O at the center. Okay, and let angle AOB be alpha. Okay, now if I draw a perpendicular line like this, and then it will intersect AB at point C, and If I further extend, then it will intersect the arc AB at point E. Okay, so now let alpha be the central angle. Okay, let alpha be the central angle. Now let small a be the area of flow section. Okay, let P be the wetted perimeter. Let R be the hydraulic mean depth. Okay, and let D be the depth of flow. Okay, so here this distance will be considered as small d. Okay, and let small b v be the velocity of flow. Okay, now look here, in triangle AOB, right, angle AOB is alpha. So can I say that angle AOC, this much angle will be alpha by 2, right? Similarly, angle BOC will be alpha by 2, right? So in right angle triangle OCB, angle alpha can be found out, right? Which, by which formula? So by cos of alpha by 2 will be equals to OC upon OB, right? Now what is OC? OC is D by 2 minus small d. And what will be OB? OB will be D by 2, right? Why? Because if angle AB, sorry, if chord AB subtends angle O at the center, then OA will be diameter by 2 and OB will be diameter by 2, right? So this will be equals to D minus 2D upon D, right? Or it will be equals to 1 minus 2D upon D, right? So this is the formula to find out central angle, right? So if you can find out alpha by 2 from this equation, then if you will double it, then you will get cos of alpha, then you will get the angle alpha, right? Now here, if I make subject to the formula small d by capital D, right, so this will be imply, this will imply D by 2 will be equals to 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos of alpha by 2. So this equation is the equation of proportionate depth. Okay, so this equation is the equation of the proportionate depth. Let me write as this as equation number 1. Okay, now let us move ahead and find out the proportionate area. Okay, so for that we need to find out area of flow, that is the small a, right? Now coming back to the figure, I want to find out area of flow, that is I want to find out this much area, right? So what will be the area of flow? Then the area will be area of this sector AOBE, right? That is this much area, this and this. So this will be the area of sector AOEB, that is AOBE, minus area of triangle, that is triangle AOB. Okay, so can I say that area of flow will be equals to area of sector AOBE minus area of triangle AOB, right? So this will be equals to 5/4 into d square into alpha by 360 minus twice the area of triangle, that is d by 2 cos alpha by 2 into d by 2 sin alpha by 2, right? So this will be equals to 5/4 d square into alpha by 360 minus 1/2 into d square by 4, I am taking common. So this will be 2 sin alpha by 2 cos alpha by 2, that will be sin alpha, right? So if I take common out 5/4 d square, then this will be alpha by 360 minus 1/2 into sin alpha by 5. Okay, so therefore proportionate area will be, proportionate area will be small a by capital A, that will be equals to 5/4 into d square into alpha by 360 minus 1/2 sin alpha by pi upon 5/4 d square. So therefore a by capital A will be equals to alpha by 360 minus 1/2 sin alpha by pi. Okay, so this is the equation of proportionate area. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Okay, now let us move ahead and find out the wetted perimeter. So wetted perimeter will be P equals to pi into d into alpha by 360. How this comes is, you look at this, that if the sewer is running full, right, if the sewer is running full, then the angle is 360 degree, then the perimeter is pi d. So if the angle is alpha, so what will be the perimeter? So it will be pi d into alpha by 360. Okay, so from there we come that wetted perimeter will be pi d into alpha by 360. Okay, now we know that capital P is pi d, therefore proportionate perimeter will be pi d into alpha by 360 upon pi d. So this will be equals to alpha by 360. So this is the equation of proportionate perimeter. Clear? Okay, so So let us now move towards the hydraulic main depth. So hydraulic main depth, that is small r, right? So small r will be small a by small p. What was small a? That was 5 by 4 into d square into alpha by 360 minus sine alpha by 2 pi, right? And what was small p? That was pi d into alpha by 360, right? So what we'll do is, so this will be equals to d by 4 into 1 minus 360 sine alpha upon 2 pi alpha, right? And we know that hydraulic mean depth for full flow is d by 4. Therefore, proportionate hydraulic mean depth will be equals to d by 4 into 1 minus 360 sine alpha upon 2 pi alpha upon d by 4, and this will be equals to 1 minus 360 sine alpha upon 2 pi alpha. Okay, so this is the equation of proportionate hydraulic mean depth. Proportionate hydraulic mean depth. Understood, students? Let us find the proportionate velocity. Okay, so here for velocity, we know that V will be equals to 1 by n r raised to 2 by 3 s raised to 1 by 2. Okay, for if the sewer is running partially full, the velocity will be small v, n will be small n, r will be small r, and s is always going to remain constant. Okay, because slope is never going to change. Okay, now in case of full flow, then capital V will be 1 by n r raised to 2 by 3 and s raised to 1 by 2. So if I take small v by capital V, then this will be n by n into r raised to 2 by 3 upon capital R raised to 2 by 3. Okay, so s will get cancelled because the bed slope or the slope at which the sewer is laid will be constant. Okay, so and Manning's constant will also remain the same, so this will also get cancelled out. So what is the final proportionate velocity? Is small r by capital R raised to 2 by 3. Okay, so that will be equals to 1 minus 360 sine alpha upon 2 pi alpha raised to 2 by 3, because we have already found out that small r by capital R is 1 minus 360 sine alpha by 2 pi alpha. So here it will be the same. The only difference will be it will be raised to 2 by 3. Clear? Discharge is small q, right? Now small q equals to small e into small v, right? So this will be a into 1 by n r raised to 2 by 3 s raised to 1 by 2, can I say, from Manning's formula, right? So therefore proportionate is small q by capital Q, right? This will be small a by capital A, capital N by small n into r by r raised to 2 by 3 s by s raised to 1 by 2. So this will be constant, So this we can neglect out. We can neglect n by n also. So therefore, small q by capital Q will be small a by capital A into small r by capital R raised to 2 by 3. So talking about small a by capital A, this will be alpha by 360 minus sin alpha by 2 pi alpha, okay, into this, that will be 1 minus 360 sin alpha upon 2 pi alpha raised to 2 by 3. Okay, so if I take common out alpha by 360 from the first bracket, then this will be alpha by 360 1 minus 360 sin alpha upon 2 pi alpha, understood, into 1 minus 360 sin alpha upon 2 pi alpha raised to 2 by 3. So this is, and so this and this are same, so can we add the power, right? So this will be equals to alpha by 360 1 minus 360 sin alpha upon 2 pi alpha raised to 5 by 3. Okay, so this is the equation of proportionate discharge, right? That is, small q by capital Q will be equals to alpha by 360 1 minus 360 sin alpha by 2 pi alpha raised to 5 by 3. Okay, that is the equation of proportionate discharge. Okay, so dear students, I hope this characteristics of sewer for partially running full will be now clear in your mind. Okay, so first we found out the central angle, how to find out the central angle, then we found out the how formula to find out the proportionate depth, then we found out the formula in order to find proportionate area, then we found out proportionate perimeter, then we found out proportionate hydraulic mean depth, then we found out proportionate velocity, and then last we found out proportionate discharge. So you will get the numericals based on this equations. Okay, so please keep this in mind for solving the numericals, which you will see in the next video.